So what I'm going to do in this video is explain what a vertical asymptote is. So it's for a rational function such as one like f of x equals g of x over h of x, where it's a quotient of a function, so a fraction, where h of x equals 0, there exists for the function f of x a vertical asymptote, which essentially means a part of the graph where the graph is no longer continuous or it doesn't exist. In order to accurately sketch f of x, we need to find not only the asymptote, but also how the function f of x approaches and leaves the asymptote. So I'm going to do three examples. Not sure how much space they're going to take, but I'll wipe some off if I need to. So we've got example one, which I'm going to do x minus 1 over x plus 1, which I'll do now. So now what I've done is I could straight away pretty much read off that the vertical asymptote is going to be at x equals negative 1, because if x equals negative 1, then the denominator of the rational function is 0, so therefore that function cannot exist. And then what I've done now, knowing that the vertical asymptote exists at x equals negative 1, I have gone to a point close to it on either side, so negative 1.01 and negative 0.99, to see how the function exists at those points. And at negative 1.01, we've got 201, so it's positive, so it's above, so it's approaching from positive infinity. And then for negative 0.99, it's approaching from negative infinity, so it's as it's negative 199. I'm not going to draw a full graph, I'm just really doing this video to show how the graph exists at asymptotes. So now I'll sketch that graph. So there what I've done is shown how that function exists at the vertical asymptote x equals negative 1. So if we knew the full graph, we would then be able to extend that on. Okay. I'm going to do example 2. So there what I've done is I've interpreted the graph and realized function and realized that the asymptotes are going to be at x equals 5 and x equals negative 1. And then I found how the graph behaves just before and after each asymptote. So f4.99, f5.01, f of -1.01, and f of -0.99. So as it approaches the asymptote x equals 5, it's coming from the negative, and then it's leaving from the positive, and then it's coming from the negative and leaving from the positive. So there, what I'm going to do is sketch though how those asymptotes behave. So there what we can see is I've sketched in how the graph behaves just before and after the asymptotes. And I just mentioned before, because I haven't there, we're expressing the asymptote as a dotted vertical line currently. So you can start to see how knowing how it behaves at the asymptote allows you to fully sketch the graph, as you can start to see where they're going to connect. The only thing that's missing we would have to work out is the y-intercepts and the roots. But that's, I want to focus really just on the vertical asymptotes in this video. So what I'll do this last question, this last example. So what I'm now going to do is show you how I'm doing this at the same time as working it out. So as you can see, calculated that at -1.01 the graph is very, very positive, so it must be approaching positive y-infinity. So now we can see that I've worked out that at -0.99 it's very negative, so it's approaching from the bottom. clear. We can start to see again how the graph starts to behave as it approaches the asymptote. So fill in a bit more. So then what that would allow you to help you see is once we knew the y-intercept and if there's any roots, it would allow you to fill in all the blanks and see how it approaches. So that is a vertical asymptote and how we calculate them and express them in functions.